Hi everybody, and welcome to this Sound Training Online track Deconstruction. Today we're going to be looking at the massive hit by Avicii, Hey Brother. We're going to be taking a look at the individual elements used to make up the track. We're going to be breaking each one down, taking a look at the theory behind it, and just seeing how the overall track is comprised essentially. I've recreated everything in Logic Pro X using presets, so we're not going to worry too much about the production techniques involved. Again, it's just looking at the theory behind the track. So let's take a quick listen to the section that we're going to be breaking down. Okay, so that's the original. As you can hear, very well produced, mixed and mastered song. So this is the recreation that I did in Logic. So we'll have a quick listen to this and then we'll start to break it down. Okay, so that's the recreation within Logic. First thing was to work out the tempo of the track. So you can see in my global tempo track, I have it worked out 125 beats per minute. If you're familiar at home with using tap tempo to work out the tempo of tracks, you could easily do that. If it's something you're not familiar with, within Logic, there's a BPM counter. So you can see here, I've just inserted it over the audio track and let the track play and it'll calculate it for you. So you can see we got 125 beats per minute here. Then the next step was to create a piano track. As we can hear in the original, there's the piano riff that's going throughout the section. We'll just have a quick listen to it here, to the whole track again. So we can definitely hear a piano layer under there of some sort. So that was the first step. I created the piano track and just tried to replicate the chords that were going on underneath there. There's quite a lot of effects on it in that section, but you can still make it out. So here we have it here. I've just created tabs across the top as well, just to show exactly what chords are going on. So the track is in G minor. So it starts off with the G minor, and we've got our G here. And then we've got our G, our B flat, and our D. So it starts off with G minor, we've got a bar there. And then it moves on to E flat major for half a bar, and then F major for half a bar. Then we're back to our G minor again for a bar. Then we've got B flat major. And then there's something quite interesting at the end here. It's a D minor, but it's a D minor seventh. So in our D minor, we've got our D, our F, and our A. So here's our D, here's our F, and here's our A. And then we've also got a C in there as well. So it's D minor seventh. And as well as that, because our A is down here in our bass note, it's an inversion. So because the A is down there, it's actually our second inversion. So at the end of our four bar progression, we've got a D minor seventh second inversion. So just a quick recap, we've got G minor to E flat major to F major, G minor to B flat major to D minor seventh, and it's the second inversion. So that's our four-bar progression that goes throughout the whole section of the track that we're looking at. Just it repeats throughout. So I'm just going to solo it up here so we can just hear this in isolation. So So that's our piano track. That's the underlying chords throughout the whole section of the song. We've got our strings here as well, and the strings just, they map them exactly. Same chords, so we've got our G minor to our E flat major to our F major, then back to G minor, B flat major, onto our D minor seventh, which is a second inversion. So we can play our piano and our strings together. I'm just going to set a loop point for this section here. Okay, so the real hook of this section is in the brass section. So we'll have a quick look at this now. So I'm going to solo this up and go into it here. So we can see that the melody throughout, it's exactly the same, just one octave up. It's just been transposed up an octave as well, just to add extra weight into the melody, just to make it more fuller sound, essentially. So we can have a quick look. As we know, the track is in G minor, so we're going to use notes within the G minor scale, and we're sticking in the natural minor scale as well, so we're not looking at the harmonic or melodic scale, so it makes things a bit easier for us. So we're going to start with our G, then we move up to our B flat, we've got our D, up to our F, and then we're up to the G, an octave up, sticking with G, coming down to an F. And then from this F, we're dropping down an octave to the F below, up to G, up to B flat, stick with B flat, then we're going up to D, up to F, up to G, up to A, back down to G, back down to F, and then down. So we're going down D, C, and then B flat. So that's our lead line there. We'll have a quick listen to it when it's soloed up. That's that. We can listen to these all together now, but the piano, the strings, and the lead brass in together. Okay, then the last element of this section is the claps as well. So I'm just going to unsolo these here, and I'm going to listen to the original track again, just so we can hear everything that's going on. So obviously we can hear from that there's a lot of effects going on as well that I haven't looked at all. There's nice filter effects going on over the piano, there's a reverb effect on the lead line, a lot of different things going on, white noise sweep up towards the end. So these are things I didn't want to spend too much time on because I wanted to focus on the theory of the track. So to put together our claps, I just took a clap from the Apple loop section. I put it on each beat, so I have it on the 1, 2, 3 and the 4 of each bar, and just I copied that out and just joined it into one region, as you can see here, over 4 bar region. So that's what I did for that. And then we've got our little drum fill here as well, which was again just from the Apple loop section. There was a longer drum fill, I just chopped this small bit out because it worked well. It was the same as the original. So that's that whole section put together. We'll have another listen to the recreated track, and then the original, and then the recreated track again. We'll be right back. Okay, so we get the idea of that. So let's move on to the next section where our drums, our full rhythm section kick in. We also got our bass line here, some white noise just to add some extra harmonic content just to fill out the sound a bit. And we've got sidechain compression going on and some high strings as well. So we'll start off with the high strings. These are identical to the original strings that we had in the track. Exactly the same. I just transpose it up one octave and put it on a separate track just for clarity's sake. So high strings, exactly the same as strings, just up one octave. Lead brass is the same. The only variation we have is just at the end here, just kind of as our little transition, just to signify the end of our 8-bar section. So from here, our melody, it continues the same as it was throughout. We have our B flat here, and then we've got a bit of a gap. Then we're going from G to F, down to D, up to F again. So we can have a quick listen to that now. So that's our lead brass section. Our bass line. This is the same as the bass progression that was in our piano track. I'm just zoom out a little bit here so we can see it. So following the same progression as earlier, we have our G minor, down to our E flat major, up to F major, back to G minor again, B flat major, and then our D minor seventh, which is the second inversion. So just what to note from here is that it's the A is the bass note, not the D, as it's the second inversion. And it continues the same again. That's our bass line. We've got our white noise track. It's just one long note of white noise. We can just hear it in the original as well. I'll just have a listen back to the original. So you can definitely hear the hiss of the white noise in there. It starts to filter down slowly as it progresses throughout, but it's very, very noticeable at the start. Then there's just some extra rhythm sections here. Just again from the Apple loops, I found just a 1-bar drum loop that worked with the tracks, so I put it in. Just the claps from earlier, I just put the claps on the 2 and the 4 of each bar. Again, a little hats loop here, galloping hats topper, worked well with the track. And then I've just used this to sidechain. So I've added some sidechain compression across the different elements just to make it sound somewhat like the original in terms of production. That's pretty much all the elements of the track broken down. I can show you the different what I've used for each instrument. So in our piano track, I've used an EXS24 sampler. I just used the Steinway Grand Piano. For our strings, again, EXS24 sampler. And I've used the string ensemble preset. High strings, it's exactly the same track duplicated down as the strings. So that's gonna be the string ensemble in the EXS24 again. Lead brass, I have the full brass section again. These are all included within Logic. Bass, I've used an ESM synthesizer. So I've used a clean bass preset and I've just tweaked it a little bit just to suit the sound from the original track a little more. And white noise, I've just used the ES2, just using oscillator 3 on the noise just to get the white noise sound effect. So that just about wraps us up. Just to finish off, I'm going to play back the original track one more time, and then I'll play the recreated track within Logic. So, here we go. and the remade version again. So that brings us to the end of this track, Deconstruction. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something from it. And if there are any other tracks that you'd like to see deconstructed, get in touch with us, leave us a comment, and let us know what you'd like to see.